already up to now. This weather scope is sponsored by Cadillac. The great performers are always creating a higher standard.
This is Weather Scope.
Good afternoon, Bill Keneally with you on the Weather Channel. A rather tumultuous morning weather-wise in Central Florida. A couple of tornadoes touching down along the I-4 corridor. Things are appearing to be winding down now, but let's get the latest on the goings-on in South Florida now. And with that, here's Declan Kennan. Okay, thanks a lot, Bill. That's right. Things are winding down. We don't have the severity that we had earlier today with numerous reports of wind-damaging thunderstorms in Central Florida. We still have some heavy rain, though, and we'll show that to you in just a moment on radar, in addition to where the tornado watch is still in effect. But this is the way it looked earlier today. The rain coming down quite hard around Hillsborough County. Winds gusting in excess of 40 to 45 miles per hour. Numerous clusters of thunderstorms developing, at least initially, over the Gulf of Mexico and then riding in on that strong upper-level wind pattern. So we did have quite a bit of rain and, as you can see, in some cases, wind damage in Hillsborough County. Also, as you head east, as Bill mentioned, up the I-4 corridor. Now, this is where the tornado watch is still in effect until 4, about another half hour from now. We haven't received any additional word from the Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma, as to whether or not we'll see an additional weather watch issued farther south, but they are monitoring the atmosphere very carefully over extreme southern Florida. We do know that today it did manage to warm up a little bit in southern Florida, a little sunshine helped there, and then the clouds rolled in, so we haven't seen much warming since about 1 or 2 o'clock this afternoon. But you notice down to the south, this is where the most intense storms are located. And we finally are starting to get a lot more of an indication that the rain shield that was almost solid across the entire central part of the peninsula, that rain shield is starting to break up now. Some drier air is trying to work its way into the area from the west, northwest. So this will be the main zone of action for the next hour or so along the coast, south of Brevard County now. Actually, as you head down towards Indian River and St. Lucie counties, right in through here, ahead southwest around Highlands and Glade County. These are the counties that will be most susceptible to catching additional severe weather, primarily in the form of some damaging wind gusts within the next hour or two. We put it into motion. That was a fairly fast-moving cluster of intense storms that made its way across Melbourne. Most of Brevard County did get some heavier downpours and some gusty winds with that line as it kicked through. Doppler radar, same perspective of the same line here. The radar out of Tampa looking to the east, you can see as you go through time here the progression off the coast to some of the showers and storms. But it now appears as we look west that we may have one more burst of heavier rain getting ready to move through Pinellas County in the next 30 to 45 minutes. The big view, as mentioned, holes in the rain shield here to the north, most intense storms down to the south.
And you do notice that as you look on the radar here to the south, we do have separate lines developing, indicating that we still have very strong winds, south to southwest winds coming into southern Florida. So although the tornado watch is in effect up and through this zone, there's still a possibility that isolated severe storms could occur in southern Florida as we're going into this evening. There's the satellite perspective, tremendous amount of low cloud behind the departing cold front. The severe storms earlier today lined up over central Florida. We did have a report of a touchdown near Intercession City about 10:15 this morning. Also, wind damage reports from Lake County and Osceola County between 9:30 and 11. And look how much rain radar estimates over south central and southeast Georgia. 6 to almost 9 inches of rainfall. We could see a ripple effect, so to speak, in the next couple of days. There could be some local flooding along the rivers here. And then as you look at our surface map, our cold front moving east of Tallahassee now, but it's still going to take us, well, probably another 3 or 4 hours before it can get down the coast to Tampa and likewise head through Orlando. And at that time, a noticeable change in the wind direction and cooler, drier air will move in overnight. Well, a look at the rest of the nation's weather and the forecast. We'll turn it back to the studio and Bill Keneally.
Thanks a lot, Declan. The folks around the Midwest are still cleaning up, especially Colorado, Nebraska, and Iowa from this past weekend's winter-like storm. Snowfall totals across the area topping out at over 4 feet in some cases. New England saw the tail end of the same storm earlier today, but there was only a smattering of snowfall. Take you up around Twin Mountain, New Hampshire. And this is, again, a little bit to the northeast of Franconia Notch, if you can kind of picture where that is. Not a whole lot fell, obviously, at the roadway level, but I'm sure several inches have accumulated up there in the highlands in the Franconia Notch on top of Mount Lafayette, for instance, and likewise around the Presidential Range of New Hampshire. At last check, I think I saw freezing rain occurring up on top of Mount Washington. Big city, safe to say, was all rain. Temperature is pretty much holding in the 40s and low 50s during the rain. Then as the sun came out today, we saw some westerly winds down sloping the air, down off of the Berkshires in Connecticut and down off of the Poconos into New York. And that brought temperatures back up to the 60s, even some 70s in southeastern Virginia. But once again, the system is rearing its ugly head in the form of winter-like weather in extreme northern Maine. Low pressure moving up into Quebec. There's a secondary low now taking shape in the Gulf of Maine, and that is holding the cold air in, kind of draining it in from New Brunswick, and that's helping to keep the rain-snow turnover from occurring in northern Maine. And we've had a decent snow, too, on the order of 4 to 8 inches here from the Allegash into the potato country there in Arosta County in Maine. 32 now in Caribou, still snowing. 41 in Bangor. It's been pretty much a rain event for you guys. 50 in Beantown with cloudy skies, but the sun is out, and with that sun, 60s for latter October, not bad in New York. However, you hop over the mountains, 40 in Pittsburgh, 41 in Charleston, 40 in Rochester, and by the way, once you get away from the impact of the milder air off of Lake Ontario and Lake Erie in the high country, we're going to see a little snowfall, especially to the east and northeast of Erie, PA. Some rain showers around Interstate 80 out there by Happy Valley and State College, Pennsylvania. And also there's your snowfall, mainly to the west of Caribou in Maine. Boston to New York in pretty good shape. But in PA, again, around, that'd be east of Youngstown, up around Newcastle, the Butler area, south and east around Indiana, PA, scattered rain showers, maybe a little bit of snow dusting the higher ridges here, getting into the Laurel Highlands later on today. This is all dropping towards the southeast. In the Midwest, we're getting a little warmer air now, but earlier we had high pressure overhead and light winds and a fresh snowpack, and you can see our snowpack very evident. There's that stripe from Lake Winnebago in Wisconsin, all across Iowa. Check out all these rivers that dump down into the Mississippi River, and just a tremendous snowpack in Nebraska. And beneath that snowpack, just a very, very cold night last night.